So it's the end of day one here in Berlin at IFA 2016. I'm joined by Michael, Max and Rich. Guys, how was your day? How was your first day here?
It's okay. Fine. It's hot, busy, but yeah.
Weather's beautiful. Michael, what have you seen today?
I've seen a lot of laptops today. Many new Acer laptops, probably more than a dozen Acer laptops. They've gone, I didn't know they had it in them to launch so many. Highlights, probably the ultra thin Spin 7 and Swift 7.
That sounds like a crap Android tablet.
I know, it's very confusing, isn't it? They're not 7 inches, they're like double. I don't get the naming schemes, it's very strange.
And what was that massive one we saw?
We had a curved screen gaming laptop, the Predator 21X. Probably my favourite gaming laptop I've ever seen. Fortunately, it wasn't a working sample, so I can't really comment any
further.
Or
at all practical.
Well, no, but you don't buy a gaming laptop for practicality, Max.
Well, one thing I can put in a bag, not as big as my TV.
Shopping bag for life.
So, Max, what have you seen today, Max?
We've seen quite a few watches. So we saw Samsung's Gear S3. There's two editions of that, the
Frontier
and the Classic.
And the Frontier.
They're both basically the same, so it's a bit odd they've given them two distinct names.
Yeah,
I've also saw Asus's new Zenwatch 3, which is forged from the steel of Mordor or whatever. But yeah, that's really nice. I think that's definitely the better looking of the two.
Richard, Obviously you're the wearables guy, so big day for you. How do you compare the Gear S3 and Asus's Zenwatch?
They're both very different. The Gear S3 is kind of a strange one. They're saying it's, a traditional analog watch, or at least kind of aping that, but it's very, very big, so it's kind of a lot more like a dedicated sports watch.
Pretty
in
chunky.
That regard. It's very, very, it's very thick, it's a bigger face compared to the S2. It's a nice watch, but it is not quite as elegant looking as the S2.
Yeah, I don't know if they're taking a step backwards with the Gear S series. I really like the Gear S2. It was a nice sort of, it's quite a small, compact little watch, but now the S3 is, I mean, it's a chunky monkey, isn't it?
Definitely is. No, I think there's a very specific reason they've kept the S2 on sale.
Yeah. Yeah, so as soon as they said they were keeping the S2 going, I think we both immediately thought
it's
that
gonna be big.
It's going to be chunky and it's going to be expensive.
And how about the Zenwatch?
It's an Android Wear watch. It's probably the worst kept secret. I think images leaked in advance of IFA. It is round as the leaks implied. It looks nice enough. It's, again, a little bit chunky.
It's not got the flat tile like the Moto 360 has. Yeah. It's running Snapdragon's new built for wearables 2100 CPUs.
Yep.
It's the first Android Wear watch to have three buttons, so you can there's sort of a dedicated shortcut button at the top and the regular menu button, and yeah, I mean, it's the first Android Wear watch sort of running the new software. There's not been a new Android Wear watch in what seems like all year, I mean, there's not much competition, and €229, so £199, £209, sort of. I think that seems quite a fair price considering, considering the competition. I mean, the Moto 360 is more expensive than that, isn't it?
So. Yeah.
So lots of laptops, lots of wearables. What are you guys up to tomorrow, Michael?
I think tomorrow we're going to be looking at the debacle that is Intel's naming strategy, because they launched their new KB Lake stuff a couple of days ago, and we've seen them in lots of these new laptops, and I think a lot of people are going to be very confused about what they're getting.
So we're going to have a chat about that tomorrow.
We're going to have a deep dive and explain what the heck's going on, because we need to really put the record straight.
Max, yourself?
It's all about the phones tomorrow. We've got Huawei in the morning, then Sony, got ZTE, Qualcomm are doing something, I think, and yeah,
lots
who knows? Who knows?
What about you, Rich?
TomTom for me tomorrow. Lots more wearables and a couple of exciting sat navs as well.
Okay. Cool. So it's been a fun first day here at IFA 2016 in Berlin. Let us know if there's anything you'd like us to see, and we'll see you again tomorrow.
Cheers.
What did you say?
Cheers.
It's like you're sneezing.